In this chapter, you'll learn the difference between saving your project and sending and receiving. To save the work that you've done so far, you can simply use the Save command from the File menu. However, this Save command will not automatically upload the changes you've made to the centrally shared Teamwork project on the BIM server. It will merely save your local copy of the file to your computer in a Teamwork database format. When your work has progressed to the point at which you wish to share it with other users, apply the Send Changes command. Doing so will upload the changes you made to the BIM server. To update your project with the contributions of the other users, apply the Receive Changes command. You can do both in one step simply by using the Send and Receive command. The difference between saving and sending and receiving means that users can decide which part of their work they would like to share with others when they use sending and receiving, while also ensuring that the project on their computer is securely saved using saving. At the end of the chapter, you will also find out what it means to be offline when you are part of the Teamwork project but not working on it, or to work offline when there is no live network connection to the BIM server. Finally, you will see how simple it is to release the elements you no longer wish to work on. Let's share the design work Architect 1 made to the washroom in the previous chapter with the other users. To do this, we must send the changes to the BIM server. Please switch to the Teamwork project of Architect 1. Open the Chapter 3.01 view from the view map of the navigator. Click the arrow button to the right of the Send Receive command on the Teamwork palette. Click the Send Changes option. Please note that you can reach the same commands from the Teamwork menu. Please notice that it took less than a second to send the changes to the BIM server due to the low network traffic generated by ArchiCAD Teamwork's Delta Server technology. This technology ensures that only the changes are sent through the network and processed by the BIM server, facilitating the sharing of large projects by architectural teams of any size. Let's switch to the Teamwork project of Architect 2. The task of Architect 2 is to create the furniture layout of the building, so let's place some dining tables and chairs in the central kitchen area. The visibility of the elements reserved by Architect 1 are not too good, so let's fix this. Select Architect 1 in the Users panel of the Teamwork palette. Use the Set User Color option, and select a slightly darker shade of yellow for Architect 1. Click OK, and notice that the contrast of the yellow elements has improved. Activate the Chapter 3.01 view in the view map of the navigator. Display the Favorites palette using the Window, Palettes menu. Double-click the dining table favorite in the list. Open the Object Default Settings dialog and display the Preview and Positioning panel. Change the home story of the dining table to Ground Floor Current so that the dining tables will be placed on the current story. Click OK to close this dialog. Zoom in if necessary, and place two dining tables with chairs into the kitchen area. Notice that the tables are in red, which is the user color of Architect 2. To see the changes that were carried out by other users, as well as to share your design input with them, let's carry out the Send and Receive command. Click Send and Receive on the Teamwork palette. The changes made by Architect 1, the new partition wall, new internal doors, and toilet objects, were received instantly and are now visible in yellow on the screen. Close the Favorites dialog. Certainly, it is also possible in ArchiCAD Teamwork to only receive the changes without sending yours. Let's see an example for this as well. Switch to the workspace of Architect 1. Apply the Receive Changes command from the Teamwork palette. Notice that the two dining tables with chairs have immediately appeared on the floor plan, and these are displayed in red, showing that they're reserved by Architect 2. When you are part of a Teamwork project, but currently not connected to the BIM server, the other users will see you as being offline. In this case, your preview picture in the Users panel of the Teamwork palette will be grayed out and have a red cross mark in it. To see an example, let's close the project of Architect 1 and see how Architect 2 will experience the other user being offline. Save the project of Architect 1. Close this project file using the File, Close Project command. Switch to the workspace of Architect 2. Notice that the preview picture of Architect 1 changed in the Users panel of the Teamwork palette. While you're working on a Teamwork project, but your connection to the BIM server is lost for any reason, for example due to network problems or the server machine breaks down, you will still be able to continue your work, albeit with some restrictions. You will not be able to change your workspace, send and receive changes, or communicate with the other users via the messaging functions. Please see the functions explained in detail later in Chapter 5. However, you will be able to work within your workspace, create new elements, or save your project. Once the communication with the BIM server is re-established, you will be able to send and receive changes again. Let's see an example of working offline. Check the Work Offline pop-up menu in the Teamwork palette and see how the menus in the Workspace panel have been grayed out. Click out of Work Offline to go back online. Notice that all the previously inactive options are active again. Save the project. Use the Release command on any currently selected element, and the element will be released instantly. It's recommended to regularly release those elements that you no longer wish to work on. This way, you can maintain a flexible workflow in the architectural office. Let's see an example of how to release selected elements. In the workspace of Architect 2, select one of the dining table objects. Click the Release button of the Workspace panel of the Teamwork palette to release the selected element. You can see how the floor plan representation of the object changes from red to blue, showing the element is no longer reserved by any users. You may hover the cursor over the dining tables and notice the differences in the info tags. Select the other dining table object. Then click with the right mouse button beside it on the floor plan to display the context menu. Select the Release Selected Elements command from the context menu. Notice that the other dining table object has also been released. Naturally, you can select more than one element and apply the Release Selected Elements command to them. The command can also be reached from the Teamwork menu. With a single click of the Release All command, all your previously released elements will be released in seconds, allowing the other users to work on them right away without having to receive the changes. Switch to the other instance of ArchiCAD. Open the Teamwork training project of Architect 1. In the Open pop-up menu, you will have the recently opened projects listed. The Teamwork projects have a special icon, and the server name and username is also listed in brackets. ArchiCAD automatically realized that this project has been modified on the server since Architect 1 last worked on it. It is a good practice to click the Receive Now button in order to receive all changes before continuing the work. Click Receive Now to proceed. The floor plan window opens with the reservations shown by user color. Please notice that the dining tables, created by Architect 2, are free for reservation. Click the My Workspace button on the Teamwork palette for an overview of the reserved elements. Click the Release All button of the Teamwork palette, or alternatively, the Release All button on the My Workspace panel. A warning message informs you that before releasing the reserved elements, you have to send the changes that you have previously made. Click the Send and Release All button to proceed. Click the My Workspace button on the Teamwork palette to check that you have no elements within your workspace. You can set a preference that your reservation be released automatically each time you close the Teamwork project. This option can be very useful to avoid accidentally holding on to model elements while you're joined in but not working on the project. Let's display the Work Environment dialog from the Options menu. Switch to the Data Safety and Integrity page under Company Standard Schemes. Display the Data Integrity panel and note the Release All when closing Teamwork Project and Send Changes option. In this chapter, you've seen several flexible ways that ArchiCAD Teamwork supports the architectural workflow by the fine-tuned sending and receiving methods. There is virtually no waiting time at synchronization due to the low network traffic generated by ArchiCAD Teamwork's Delta Server technology. Only the changes are sent through the network and processed by the servers or clients. Teams of any size can collaborate due to fast send and receive operations. Project information and user statuses are always kept up to date between all the users. You also saw how ArchiCAD Teamwork supports offline work methods. In case of network failure, users can continue their work and save the project locally. Once the network connection is re-established, they can again send and receive changes to and from the BIM server. You've also seen how easy it is to release the elements that you do not wish to edit any longer.